Tegeta A, we are blessed to have this man of God. I met this man from when I was in Germany. This man is born in America, ministering in Germany, called in Africa. We love this man very much. We have him the whole week till Sunday. You will never be the same again. Allow me, men, to invite this man of God all the way from Germany, Pastor Mark Irvin. Welcome, sir. God bless you. Amen.
Yes, it's wonderful to be back in Tanzania.
Dio ni furaha kuwa tena Tanzania.
Hallelujah, Jesus is Lord over Tanzania.
Hallelujah, Yesu ni Bwana juu ya Tanzania.
This is what we say. This is what we proclaim. We lift up the name of Jesus.
Tunainua jina la Yesu.
Jesus is Lord.
Yesu ni Bwana.
Father, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Baba katika jina kuu la Yesu.
We ask you right now.
Tunakuomba sasa hivi.
To move.
Utembee.
Through the power of the Holy Spirit.
Kupitia nguvu za Roho Mtakatifu.
Father, you have a plan.
Mungu una mpango.
For this night.
Kwa jioni ya leo.
You have a plan for this crusade.
Una mpango kwa ajili ya mkutano huu.
You have a plan for this time and for this nation.
Una mpango kwa ajili ya saa hii na kwa ajili ya taifa hili.
You have begun a good work.
Umeanzisha kazi nzuri.
And you will finish it.
Na utamaliza.
Finish it until the return of your son Jesus Christ.
Utamaliza kupitia jina la mwana wako Yesu Kristo.
And we pray right now.
Na tunaomba sasa.
That you move.
Kwamba utembee.
Confirming the word.
Ukithibitisha neno.
With signs and wonders following.
Kwa ishara na maajabu zikifuata.
You watch over your word to perform it.
Unaangalia neno lako kulitimiza.
We pray for every person.
Tunaomba kwa kila mtu.
At the sound of my voice.
Anayesikia sauti yangu.
Who hears this message.
Anayesikia huu ujumbe.
For your goodness to be shown unto them.
Kwamba wema wako uonekane juu yao.
For your love to be known.
Na upendo wako kujulikane.
For your conviction to come.
Na wakaweza dhamira zao kubadilishwa.
That they would get to know you.
Ili wapate kujua wewe.
Not as a God that's way out there somewhere.
Kwamba wewe ni Mungu tu ambaye hauko mahali fulani.
But a God that becomes a father in their life.
Kwamba lakini Mungu ambaye utafanyika baba kwenye maisha yao.
They getting to know you.
Ili wapate kujua wewe.
As a son.
Kama mwana.
As a daughter.
Kama mwana na.
Through your son Jesus Christ.
Kupitia mwana wako Yesu Kristo.
We pray.
Tunaomba.
That the blessing be revealed.
Kwamba ubarikiwe kaonekane.
The blessing that sets people free from the curse.
Baraka inaweka watu huru kutoka mbali na laana.
That the devil would be known as who he is.
Na shetani akajulikane jinsi alivyo.
A destroyer.
Kwamba yeye ni mharibifu.
A liar.
Kwamba yeye ni mwongo.
A thief.
Yeye ni mwizi.
One that holds people in bondage.
Anashikilia watu katika utumwa.
And that the people would know.
Na watu wakajue.
That through Jesus Christ.
Kupitia Yesu Kristo.
We have been freed.
Tumewekwa huru.
Freed from the curse of sin.
Mbali kutoka na dhambi kutoka na laana za dhambi.
Free from the curse of poverty.
Mbali na laana ya umaskini.
And freed from the curse of sickness.
Na huru kutoka na mbali na magonjwa.
I'm a good news preacher.
Mimi ni mhubiri wa habari njema.
And I come from Germany to bring good news to the people of Tanzania.
Na natoka Ujerumani kuleta habari njema kwa watu wa Tanzania.
And this is what we pray.
Na hiki ndio tumekiomba.
At this place tonight.
Kama katika eneo hili jioni leo.
And through throughout this whole week.
Na kupitia wiki nzima.
Do what you do, Father.
Fanya kile unachofanya, Baba.
And say what you say.
Na useme kile unachokisema.
I yield myself to you.
Najiachilia kwako.
Jesus Christ.
Yesu Kristo.
Let's say. Yesterday,
jana,
today,
leo,
and forever.
Na milele yote.
In Jesus' name.
Katika jina la Yesu.
We pray.
Tumeomba.
Amen.
Amen.
Tonight,
jioni ya leo,
is the beginning.
Ni mwanzo.
Of a crusade here in Tanzania,
wa mkutano hapa Tanzania,
in a brand new place.
Katika sehemu mpya kabisa.
God does big things.
Mungu anafanya mambo makubwa.
And little places.
Katika maeneo madogo.
Jesus was born.
Yesu alizaliwa.
In a town called Bethlehem.
Katika mji unaoitwa Bethlehem.
It was a little place.
Ulikuwa ni mji mdogo.
I remember.
Nakumbuka.
When I first met Bishop Charles.
Nilipokutana na Askofu Charles.
It was about 7 years ago.
Ni kama miaka saba iliyopita.
We met in Germany.
Tulikutana kule Ujerumani.
I didn't know.
Sikuelewa.
That God would use this man.
Kama Mungu amemtumia mtu huyu.
To open up Africa.
Kufungua Afrika kwa ajili ya.
To open up Tanzania.
Kufungua Tanzania.
The Lord had spoke to me.
Na Bwana akaniambia.
And he said I'm going to open up Africa for you.
Na kwa kufungua Afrika kwa ajili yako.
Shortly after that.
Na muda mfupi baada ya hilo.
There was a man that came to a meeting.
Kuna mtu alikuja katika mkutano.
I didn't know this man.
Sikumjua huyo mtu.
I didn't know anything about him.
Sikujua chochote kuhusiana na yeye.
But God spoke and he said that's the man.
Na Mungu akasema huyo ndio yule mtu.
That's the man that's going to open up the nation of Africa.
Atakayefungua mataifa ya Afrika.
I invited this man for a pizza.
Nikamkaribisha mtu kwa ajili ya pizza.
Well, in Germany they have all kinds of pizzas.
Kule Ujerumani kuna pizza za aina mbalimbali.
But one thing about this man, Bishop Charles.
Na kitu kimoja kuhusu mtu huyu Askofu Jangalasoni.
He likes pizza with chicken on it.
Anapenda pizza yenye kuku juu yake.
So we ordered a chicken pizza.
Kwa order chicken pizza.
He said, "Would you like to come to Africa someday?"
Akauza utapenda kuja Afrika siku moja.
I was a speaker at that conference.
Nilikuwa ni mhudumu katika mkutano ule.
And we were teaching the message about who we are in Christ.
Nilikuwa nafundisha ujumbe kwamba sisi ni kanisa katika Kristo.
I said yes.
Nikasema ndio.
I would like to come to Africa.
Nitapenda kuja Afrika.
God had just said I'm going to open up Africa.
Na Mungu alisema atafungua Afrika.
And so he invited me to come.
Kwa hiyo akanikaribisha kuja.
And we came to a place not too far from here where the church is located.
Tulikuja mahali ambapo sio mbali na hapa ambapo kanisa lilipo.
There weren't any houses around the church.
Hakukuwa na nyumba nyingi pale kanisani.
We had a generator for electricity.
Tulikuwa tukitumia generator kwa ajili ya umeme.
We did everything we could to have a great meeting.
Tulifanya kila tunachoweza kuweza kupata mkutano mkubwa.
And God began to move in a mighty way.
Na Mungu akaanza kutembea kwa jinsi kubwa.
There was a woman that came.
Kulikuwa kuna mwanamke alikuja.
This woman could not speak.
Huyu mwanamke alikuja akaweza kuongea.
She could not hear.
Akuweza kusikia.
And in that meeting,
katika huo mkutano,
God opened up her ears.
Mungu akafungua masikio yake.
And she began to speak.
Akaanza kuongea.
She pointed.
Akaanza nyosha hivi.
She told the person that brought her.
Akamwambia yule mtu aliyemleta.
She told Bishop Charles.
Akamwambia mchungaji Ngarason.
Through lip speaking.
Kwa kuongea kwa kinywa chake.
I can hear.
Naweza kusikia.
Something happened.
Kuna kitu kimetokea.
She can begin to hear.
Akaendelea kusikia.
Since then she's learned to speak Swahili.
Kuanzia hapo akaanza kujifunza kuongea Kiswahili.
It's a great wonder.
Hiyo ni muujiza mkubwa.
It's a great miracle.
Ni muujiza mkubwa.
I have come planning to teach.
Nilikuja nikipanga kufundisha.
But God turned that into a mini crusade.
Lakini Mungu akageuza kuwa mikutano mikubwa ya injili.
And over 60 people in that little mini crusade came to know Jesus Christ as Savior.
Now watu sita katika mkutano mdogo wakamjua Yesu kama Bwana Mwokozi wa maisha yao.
It was a great beginning. Bishop Charles said, this is where God told me to start a church. And so we began to believe God for great things. Well, now there are all kinds of houses around this area. There's electricity here. There are roads here. The message that I have for you tonight comes from the book of Corinthians. 2 Corinthians, the 5th chapter, it says in verse 17, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Look at your neighbor and say, all things are passed away. And all things have become new. And all things are of God, who reconciled us unto himself by Jesus Christ, who hath given unto us the ministry of reconciliation, to wit, that God was in Christ reconciling the world unto himself, not imputing their trespasses unto them, and hath committed unto us the word of reconciliation. And verse
20.
And this is the main verse. For this night. For this crusade. Now then, we are ambassadors. For God,
kwa ajili ya Kristo,
we are ambassadors for Christ.
Ni wajumbe kwa Kristo.
As though God did beseech you by us, we pray you in Christ's stead.
Kana kwamba Mungu anasikwa vya vyetu,
be ye reconciled unto God.
Tuomba ninyi kwa ajili ya patanisho na Mungu.
When I was 16 years old,
nilipokuwa na miaka 16,
God gave me a vision.
Mungu akanipatia maono.
I was praying.
Nilikuwa naomba.
God, what do you want to do with my life?
Mungu anataka kufanya nini na maisha yangu?
What is your plan?
Mpango wako ni nini?
What is your purpose?
Makusudi yako ni nini?
I was riding in a car.
Nilikuwa naendesha kwenye gari.
Down by Houston, Texas, in the southern part of America.
Houston, Texas, Marekani.
And as I was riding in this car,
gari,
we were on a main street on an interstate.
Katika,
I had a vision from the Lord.
Maono kwa Mungu.
And I saw, like, going to the movie.
Come again.
I saw, like, going to the movie theater or watching television. And I saw a street. And it was going straight. And then it curved off. And as it curved off, there was a flag. And I went to that flag. And then there was another one. And I went to another one. And another one. And another one.
nyingine.
And at the end of the vision,
na mwisho maono,
I went into Mexico.
Nikaenda Mexico,
and I saw a sign.
Nikaona ishara.
And a sign said in Spanish, "The party."
Na kama katika kile kibao inasema party.
I didn't know Spanish at the time.
Sikujua Kispanish wakati ule.
But later on, I found out that's what it means. And God said through the vision, this is what I've called you to do. You're going to go on a straight road. Well, for 36 years, I was on a straight road. I began to minister the word of God in the United States of America as a pastor. I started a church. I ministered God's word in the church. Then I went to another place, started another church, another church, and then I began to travel. And God said in the year of 2000, this year you are going to start going to the nations. And so I went to Germany and started there.
Began
a Bible school, had more training, more preparation. And then the time that I met Bishop Charles, the Lord said, now you will begin to go from nation to nation to nation.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So that's what we're doing tonight. I'm here as a representative of the Lord Jesus Christ. And when I go to different nations, I go in His name as an ambassador. You see, Jesus, He is not here. He is in heaven, seated at the right hand of God. And He said to His disciples and to believers, He said, the works that I do will you do also, and greater works than these shall you do, because I go to the Father. So Jesus, He's in heaven, but Jesus has called every son and daughter of God to go somewhere and do something, the same thing that He does. Well, the Bible says in these verses that we read tonight that He's given us the ministry of reconciliation. The word reconciliation, it means to reestablish relationship. You see, when God created man, He created man to have relationship. Tell your neighbor that God wants you to know Him in a personal way. He's not a God that's just way out there somewhere. I know Him. He's my Father. My translator knows Him. He's his Father. Bishop Charles knows Him. We know Him in a personal way. When we get up in the morning, we talk to Him. When we ride in our cars like we did coming here tonight, we talk to Him. He's our Father. When we preach, we talk to Him. I'm talking to Him right now. I'm saying, Father, what do you want to say to the people? You have something to say.
kusema.
So I'm checking on the inside.
Pale naangalia ndani.
And what's coming out of me?
Kile kinachotoka ndani mwangu.
Is what's coming on the inside of me.
Ni kile kinachotoka ndani mwangu.
I know him in a personal way.
Ninamjua kibinafsi.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
There was a time that I didn't know him. He was this God way out there. Jesus was this person that was on a cross. I didn't know him. And someone came along. And they told me why Jesus hung on the cross. Because God loved me. He loves man. He wants relationship with man. You see, no other person has given their life for mankind. Only Jesus.
Yes,
and Jesus' main reason for coming was to reestablish a broken relationship. When God created Adam in the beginning, God and Adam fellowshipped. They walked together in the cool of the day. God is the ruler of heaven. He created earth. And then he said, man, here's your earth. You do on earth what I do in heaven. When God and Adam got together, they had things to talk about. But then there was a devil. A bad devil. And the devil, who at one time also was in right place with God, who lost his relationship with God, who came to the earth after God put man in the earth, he hated God, and man was in the earth representing God in the earth. He said, I'm going to do what I can to destroy man and to destroy this relationship that man has with God. And so the devil, he tempted man and got man to sin. And when man sinned, the relationship with God was broken. This is why man doesn't know God.
Na hii ndio maana watu hamjui Mungu.
This is why man doesn't experience the love of God.
Na ndio maana mwanadamu hawezi kupata upendo wa Mungu.
This is why there's sin in the earth.
Na ndio maana kuna dhambi duniani.
This is why there's sickness in the earth.
Na ndio maana kuna magonjwa duniani.
This is why there's death in the earth.
Na ndio maana kuna kifo duniani.
If you've had a hard time, a difficult life,
kama umekuwa na maisha magumu na wakati mgumu,
I tell you something, that was not because of a loving God. It was because of a bad, mean devil. The devil is never for you. He's always against you. And if you have never received Jesus Christ in your life, you're living on the wrong side. But I'm telling you, there's a better side. There's a loving God. And he wants you free from all those bad things that the devil brought in this earth. And as an ambassador, that represents the Lord Jesus Christ here in the earth, I've got a message for you to deliver unto you. There's a different kingdom than the kingdom that is in this earth right now. There's a different law than the law of sin and death that's in this earth right now. I was was talking with Bishop Charles on the way here. And I said, Bishop Charles, could you tell me the story again about the time that you were a student down in South Africa? Because I remember the first time he so told his story and had such impact. There was a time when he was a student in South Africa, and he was coming from South Africa back to Tanzania, and he was going through the customs to leave. And when you go through customs, you have to show your passport. And the authorities in South Africa, they looked at his passport, and they said, sir Bishop, you have overstayed your time here in South Africa. And because you have overstayed your time here, you have to come with us. And so they grabbed him, and they took him to their boss. These were the policemen at the border. And if you overstay your time, they can throw you in jail. He tried to tell him, listen, I didn't overstay. You're looking at an old visa. There's another visa in there with another date. They didn't listen to what he had to say. We're the authority here. You come with us. So they took him to their boss. But you know what? He knows that he comes from the nation of Tanzania. And he knows that Tanzania has certain laws to protect their citizens. And even though his residence is here, when he goes to South Africa, he's protected. And he knows in my passport is a valid visa. And so he could relax. Oh yeah, we'll see what happens here. So he goes before the boss. But you know what? In his pocket, he has a telephone number. And you know what the telephone number is? It's the telephone number of the ambassador of Tanzania. He's before the boss. The police boss. He's before the police boss. And he says, sir, police boss, I got a telephone number here. And it's the ambassador's number of Tanzania. And he said, now you look in my passport. These guys would not listen to me. But you better listen to me. Because if you don't listen to me, I'm going to be sleeping in a 5-star hotel tonight. You better stop that airplane. Because I'm going home today. And you put me up in a 5-star hotel right now. Or I'm calling the ambassador. Sure enough, the boss, he looked. Don't call the ambassador. Please. Don't call the ambassador. The boss.
Yule boss.
And the policemen were down on their knees.
And wait.
Come again.
They couldn't leave. Instead of taking Bishop Charles to the bus and to jail, they called the police car man. They said, hurry up. Get over here. Get Bishop Charles. Pick him up. They fly him. Business class.
Katika business class.
They apologize to all the passengers. Now here's the point.
Point yangu iko hapa.
This is how much power an ambassador has. And Paul wrote this. And he said, listen. He said, I am a representative of the Lord Jesus Christ. And Tanzanians. Listen. I am a representative of the Lord Jesus Christ. I didn't just come from America. I didn't just come from Germany. But I'm from the kingdom of God. Jesus Christ. And I'm telling you, through Jesus Christ, your sins have been forgiven. I'm telling you, through Jesus Christ, you don't have to be sick anymore. Jesus says, I took your sin on the cross. I died for you. You could be free from the nature of sin that you got.
Come again.
That you receive because of what Adam did. Jesus paid the price. He took the sin on the cross so that you could become a brand new person tonight. Hallelujah. The devil will come along and he'll tell you, you can't be healed. You're gonna die of that cancer. You're gonna die of that
malaria.
You're gonna die of that disease. You can't ever walk again. You can't be healed of that blindness. I'm here to tell you tonight, there's a law that comes from another kingdom, and that's the kingdom that I represent. And that law is called the Spirit of Life in Christ Jesus. And Jesus took stripes in his body for your healing. Tonight is your night to receive the benefits of another kingdom. mwingine.
You don't have to stay in a dark
place.
You don't have to stay in the nation of this world that's full of
sin.
That's full of sickness. That's full of poverty. Christ has redeemed us from the curse. I'm an ambassador from the kingdom of heaven. And my question to you tonight is, would you like to come into my kingdom? Do you
want
to just live in Tanzania? Or would you like to live in Tanzania with God's kingdom? In you. In you. In you. Jesus. He's the way. He's the way. You gotta understand that when an ambassador speaks, it's as if the president speaks. And Jesus is telling you tonight that I've forgiven you. He's telling you tonight that I have healed you. He's telling you tonight, come on,
show.
Come on,
show
your relationship with God can be restored. You don't have to be away from God anymore. You can know Him in a personal way. Jesus is the 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 way. No other religion has a person that came and gave his life and died. No other religion has a person that came and raised from the dead. No other religion has this kind of love. You can know God in a loving way. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So I want you to ask yourself tonight, if you were to die, would you be ready to meet God way up there somewhere? Would you be ready tonight? Have you been listening to excuses that the devil has told you that you can never know God, that you're a terrible person? Or tonight, would you like to accept God's answer? You cannot save yourself. You can never do enough good. You could never give enough. You could never love enough. You see, the man's righteousness can never equal God's righteousness. And this is why Jesus came. He became sin on the cross, that we could receive God's righteousness, His forgiveness. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So I want to ask you tonight, do you want to know God? Do you want to know Jesus? Do you want to come into the kingdom? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus died for you. He paid the price for you. Father, I pray in the mighty name of Jesus, deep into the hearts, show yourself tonight. Are you ready?
Uko tayari?
Father, move.
Mungu tembea baba.
Move.
Tembea.
I want you to bow your head and close your eyes.
Nataka kila mmoja ainamishe kichwa chake na afunge macho.
Do you have a time?
Je unao muda?
In your life.
Katika maisha yako.
Where you prayed.
Unapoomba.
And said Jesus.
Na kusema Yesu.
I believe in you.
Na kuamini.
As my savior.
Kama mwokozi wangu.
That you died.
Kwamba ulikufa.
That you rose from the dead.
Na ukafufuka kutoka kwa wafu.
If you want to pray that prayer tonight,
kama unataka kuomba ombi hilo jioni leo,
I'm going to pray with you.
Nitaomba na wewe.
Lift your hand right now.
Kama unataka kuomba maombi haya kukaribisha Yesu kwenye maisha yako, nyosha mkono wako popote ulipo. Ili tuombe, mwambie atakuomba na wewe. Nyosha mkono wako, unataka kuokoka.
There's one.
Kuna usiogope, nyosha mkono. Nyosha mkono, kuna mkono kule. Dada pale, usiogope, nyosha mkono wako, nimekuona. Nyosha mkono, unataka kumpa Yesu maisha yako. Aye Bwana mwokoze maisha yako. Nyosha tu mkono pale, usiogope dada pale.
There's another one.
Kuna mwingine pale.
You're here tonight.
Uko mahali hapa jioni leo.
And you've never prayed.
Na ukuomba maombi haya.
And receive God's answer.
Ya kupokea majibu ya Mungu.
Jesus.
Yesu.
Is who you're looking for.
Ni wewe ulikuwa unanitafuta.
You will never be satisfied.
Haujaweza kujitosheleza.
Until you come into relationship with a loving God.
Sasa unakuja kwa mahusiano ya karibu na Mungu mwenye upendo.
Who wants Jesus tonight?
Nani anamhitaji Yesu jioni leo?
Lift your hand.
Shosha mkono wako, unamhitaji Yesu, una mahusiano mazuri na Yesu.
Are you ready to meet God?
Uko tayari kukutana na Mungu?
If you were to die tonight.
Kama ukifa jioni leo.
Would you be ready?
Utakuwa uko tayari?
To meet God.
Kukutana na Mungu.
Jesus is your answer.
Yesu ni jibu lako.
Are you looking for love?
Je, unatafuta upendo?
No man, no woman will provide the kind of love that I'm talking about tonight.
Hakuna mwanamke, hakuna mwanaume anaweza kupatia upendo ambao nauzungumzia jioni ya leo.
Those of you that want to receive Jesus, come forward and I want to pray for you.
Wewe unyosha mkono wako, sogea mbele, huyu mtu asaidie. Sogea hapa mbele, kaka pale. Sogea tu, usiogope, sogea.
We're going to have to work on the sound.
Dada pale, sogea.
This is really.
Yeah, na pia fundi mitambo kuna kelele nyingi sana inatudisturb. Jaribu kufanya kazi nzuri.
Come on, sir.
Sogea. Usiogope, kama unyosha mkono wako.
Come on up.
Usiogope. Amen.
Come on, you guys.
Wapigieni makofi jamani unapokuja. Mungu awabariki sana. Toa hai na geni hizo zipo.
Don't be shy.
Usione aibu.
Anybody else you want to receive Jesus tonight?
Mwingine anataka kumpokea Yesu jioni leo.
Come on up.
Njoo.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Sante Yesu.
This is your night.
Uni usiku wako.
Don't let your neighbor talk you out of it.
Usimruhusu mtu mwingine akuondoe.
This is your night.
Uni usiku wako.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I want you guys to pray a very simple prayer with me.
Nataka nyie muombe maombi haya pamoja na mimi. Rudia nyuma yangu.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Asante, yes.
Anybody else?
Mwingine atakuokoka?
You'll never forget this night.
Hautasahau usiku.
It's okay if you stay up there. Thank you, Lord. All right, here we go. You ready?
Uko tayari? Hata kama kule nyuma pia maombi haya nyuma yangu.
You know what?
Unajua nini?
You guys are making the most important decision in your life.
Unafanya maamuzi mazuri sana kwenye maisha yenu.
And I want you to pray a simple prayer with me. I'll pray in English.
Nitaomba kwa Kiingereza na nyie mtaomba nyuma ya mimi, nitafsiri.
And then you can pray in Swahili.
Utaomba kwa Kiswahili.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tonight, Jesus.
Sema jioni ya leo Yesu. Kwa sauti.
Jioni ya leo Yesu.
I receive you.
Na kupokea wewe.
Na kupokea wewe.
Jesus, I believe you died on the cross.
Yesu naamini ukufa kwa msalabani.
Yesu naamini ukufa msalabani.
And you took my sins.
Na ukachukua dhambi zangu.
Na ukachukua dhambi zangu.
And I believe that.
Na naamini hilo.
Jesus, you went to hell.
Kwamba Yesu ulienda kuzimu.
Kwamba Yesu
ulienda kuzimu.
Ulienda kuzimu.
For me.
Kwa ajili yangu.
And I believe that.
Na naamini hilo.
Na naamini hilo.
Jesus, you raised from the dead.
Na Yesu ulifufuka kutoka kwa wafu.
Na Yesu ulifufuka kutoka kwa wafu.
And I believe that.
Na naamini hilo.
Na naamini hilo.
Jesus.
Yesu.
Yesu.
I receive you tonight.
Na kupokea jioni ya leo.
Na kupokea jioni ya leo.
As my Lord.
Kama Bwana wangu.
Kama Bwana wangu.
And my Savior.
Na Mwokozi wangu.
Na Mwokozi wangu.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Wow.
Pige Yesu makofi.
Yes, sir.
Wonderful. It's the greatest decision you'll ever make in your life. Get into a good church. They'll help you grow.
Uende kanisani, watakusaidia kukua.
And find out what God wants you to do with your life.
Na utafute kile Mungu atakufanya na maisha yako.
He's got a plan and a purpose for your life.
Ana mpango na makusudi kwa ajili ya maisha yako.
And you know what?
Unajua kitu?
The Bible says.
Biblia inasema.
All of heaven rejoices.
Kwamba mbingu yote inashangilia.
That's the greatest miracle.
Hiyo ni muujiza mkubwa.
Is when somebody gives their life to Jesus.
Mtu mmoja anapotoa maisha yake kwa Yesu.
And tonight you are brand new.
Na leo umekuwa watu wapya.
Wonderful.
Hallelujah. Nzuri.
God bless. Ongera,
pokea mkono.
Hallelujah.
Mungu akubariki. Amen. Amen.
Who needs healing in their body today? If you need healing in your body, could you lift your hand right now? Any pain in your body? I
want
to pray for you tonight.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
All right, Bishop Charles.
Just. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
How many are blessed today? How many are happy tonight? This is just a beginning. There is a great things ahead of us. I know this man of God. God uses him a lot. I was with him in
Uganda.
I was with him in Kenya. I was with him in Germany. I've seen great miracles. Get ready. This is your week. We are here so that you may be blessed. We love you so much. We come from very near, the church of Hofan.
Kanisa la Hofani.
Hope for all nations.
Matumaini kwa mataifa yote.
We are just here.
Tuko hapa pa.
This is our city.
Huu ni mji wetu.
God bless you so much.
Mungu akubariki sana.
Welcome and tell us what to do.
Karibu tuambie cha kufanya.
Amen.
Amen.
Are you people blessed?
Yeah, you watu mbarikiwa.
Are you people blessed?
Mbarikiwa.
Today we were a little bit late.
Leo tumeanza tumechelewa.
Today we were a little bit late.
Leo tumeanza tumechelewa kidogo.
But tomorrow I assure you.
Kesho nakuahidi.
We have many singers.
Tuna waimbaji wengi zaidi.
Who are invited?
Ambao wamekaribishwa.
Including Gertrude.
Okay, pamoja na Gertrude.
God is good.
Mungu ni mwema.
God bless you.
Mungu akubariki.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Kwa tuweze kuwahi na